taking you!
Damn it! I saw someone.
What?
Got him! Get the bad guy and kill him!
What you running for?
Bounties. Topping off. Yes. Scrap. I can fix this. That'll hold. Use this. Fuel can. Should be it. Hello, squatter camp. The sons of bitches have been setting up ambushes around here, yeah? Fresh meat. can't let any of them get out of here alive. A bunch of rapists and murderers.
Where'd he go?
One down. Let's do this.
I know where you're at.
Oh my God. What do you think now, huh? Somebody shoots back. How do you like that? I gotta reload.
We're good.
It was here.
Find him! He didn't go far.
No, I got you.
Get the bastard! He killed him!
Yes, Flynn. Gotta finish this.
I see you running around.
That's the last of him. Guess your days of setting ambushes around here are over. I wonder if they had a bunker around here. I'll bet they do.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. But last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds, or rippers, or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive, the strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Not something, Cope. Law and order are a thing of the past. What the hell are you talking about?
But yeah, you got a point about force being the only thing that matters now. Force and a lot of goddamn ammo.
Here it is.
Better than nothing.
they got here?
A map, yes.
Got some papers, notes on crafting.
Yeah.
Doesn't look too bad.
I gotta burn him out. I gotta make it safer to ride. I guess I'll come back here and finish burning this infestation zone later. Yeah, that's right. I gotta burn out the rest of these nests. Yes! I smell it. Gotta be getting close. Here's another nest. Let's burn it up. Thank you.
Weeping Angel. This has gotta be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
Gotta take a closer look. Okay, let's see. What's going on here?
Maybe in one of these.
Boozman, are you listening? No, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
Yeah. Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Suit. Yeah. Hope I'm not getting sick. Field Note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 600, we've been able to confirm the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Didn't you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're sleeping like babies.
And I asked if you were going in. Let's say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit, but not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population?
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn. Stay low.